Hello and welcome. You're watching Market Head Start on Money Control. I'm Sakshi Batra, and this is where we get you prepared for the trading setup of the day. I also have with me Kshitij Anand. He's the Markets Editor at Money Control. Good morning, Kshitij, and thanks very much for joining in. Well, after two consecutive days of gains on the D Street yesterday, we actually witnessed some bit of consolidation with the Sensex and the Nifty slipping in the red. Yes. But what are the big cues that you're getting for today, which is the Valentine's Day? And do you think the bulls will get some love on a day like today?
Absolutely. Well, good morning, Sakshi, and good morning, viewers. I hope investors find their love in terms of stocks that they want to buy in today's trading session. Well, if you look at what really happened in yesterday's trading session, then yes, it was a day of consolidation. Sensex slipped by more than 100 points. Nifty 50 slipped below its crucial support placed at 12,200 levels, but still closed above 12,126, which is the 50 days moving average. So that's a positive sign, at least in the near term. Now, what is really weighing on the markets at this point in time? Like I said earlier as well, that it is the global cues which is really impacting the markets at this point in time, and actually dictating the trajectory, at least in the short term. Now, you know, with respect to the global cues, US markets ended lower. Asian markets are also trading with some bit of, you know, negative bias, as new cases with respect to coronavirus have actually increased and the deaths have also increased. So that is something which has sort of spooked the market. So from risk on to risk off sentiment has been triggered on the markets again, and that is why it is fueling a rally or some bit of rally with respect to the you know, safe haven metals such as gold and silver. So we are seeing some bit of positive reaction over there. Apart from that, if you look at you know, with respect to the post market hours, SEBI also came out with regulations with respect to portfolio fund managers, and they have actually rationalized the expense structure. So what it'll do is it'll make more, you could say, for investors, it'll make it more profitable for PMS schemes. I mean, for investors, portfolio management schemes will be much more affordable. That's what you know, SEBI is trying to do by rationalizing the structure. Now, apart from that, if you look at the rupee, then it actually closed around about flat, which is again a positive sign. At least it's not depreciated, because crude oil prices actually inched above, you know, around about $56 a barrel. Another good news is that foreign portfolio investors were net buyers in Indian markets for more than 1,000 odd crores. So that is again a positive sign. So at this point in time, I think the crucial level to watch out for investors would be 12,126 on the downside. Although we could start in the green, but then again we could face some bit of selling pressure at 12,200 levels. So if in case we do face that pressure, then 12,126, which is the 50 days moving average, and yesterday's intraday low, which is around about 12,139, will be an important level to watch out for.
All right, so the markets may consolidate further, and those are the cues that we are getting from across the globe right now. But on the domestic front, all the focus is on the earnings season, because more and more companies are reporting their earnings as we inch towards the close of this season as well. So today again, we'll be having some about 900 companies reporting their earnings. So Kshitij, which are the top companies that you're eyeing in terms of earnings, and what kind of earnings are you expecting there?
Right. Well, around about 937 companies on the BSE will be declaring the results for the quarter ended December. Now, the first prominent one being ONGC. Net profit is likely to fall by 39% on a year-on-year basis. For Muthoot Finance, the net profit is likely to grow by 31% on a year-on-year basis. For Sun TV, net profit is likely to grow by 23% on a year-on-year basis. And from the pharma space, we have Glenmark Pharma. Here, the net profit is likely to fall by 13% on a year-on-year basis. Now, remember, all the estimates are from Motilal Oswal.
All right, so those are the important earnings that you need to watch out for, and they will also be very important to watch in terms of the action they get on the earnings as well. But apart from this, we also must focus on what are the technical charts really suggesting at the moment. So, Kshitij, could you really help us understand what will be the crucial levels to watch out for today?
Absolutely. Well, you know, if you look at the whole week, Sakshi, I mean, it has been a volatile week for Indian markets. And and the good part is that we are able to sustain above crucial support levels, and we have not seen a breakdown as such. So, yes, that is definitely a positive sign, at least for the bulls in the near term.
Correct.
Now, with respect to the levels, what investors have to understand is that even though we made a bearish kind of a candle on the daily charts in yesterday's trading session, and we broke below 12,200, which was something you could say a writing on the wall, because 12,200 levels was a crucial bit of resistance for the Indian markets because of the call open interest. But now the good part is that the call open interest has actually pushed upwards. That means the maximum call open interest is placed at what, 12,500 and 12,400. It is no longer at 12,200, so that opens up some bit of room for the Nifty to actually climb above without much of a resistance now. So that is one big factor. So yes, if in case we do see some bit of positive news and we are able to climb above 12,200 levels, a larger probability that we should be able to hold on to it. Now, if in case we do consolidate and we see some bit of selling pressure, then yes, 12,139, which is the intraday low of Thursday, will be an important support. And below that, 50 days moving average, 12,126. And in case we reach that level as well, then 12,100 is an important support which Nifty should hold in today's trading session. Apart from that, on the high side, 12,232 and 12,250 are the important resistance level to watch out for. So, all in all, I think actually it should be a day of consolidation for Indian markets. But it will be important to see if Nifty is able to hold on to that crucial level which we talked about right now.
Absolutely, it is a very essential for the Nifty to hold on to those crucial support levels if we really need to see the markets inch up higher from these current levels as well. And these are the important levels that you should remember, as they will also define the trading range also for the session today. But apart from this, if you really need to have a stock-specific approach, well, there are a whole host of stocks that will be in action on the back of news flows and on the back of earnings as well. Right. So, Kshitij, top stocks on your radar.
Right. Well, the first stock that we have on the list is Apollo Hospital Enterprise. In fact, the company has recorded a consolidated profit of 89 crores during the quarter ended December, as against 49.87 crores during the corresponding period last year. Apart from that, telecom stocks will be in focus. Now, the Supreme Court will hear fresh pleas from telecom firms, including Bharti Airtel, Vodafone Idea and Tata Teleservices, seeking a new schedule of payment of statutory dues to the tune of 1.47 lakh crores to the Department of Telecommunication. Remember, now any judgment around the telecom companies will impact telecom sector, yes, and the other sector would be impacted would be the banking sector. So yes, we saw some bit of negative reaction in terms of banking sector in yesterday's trading session as well. Apart from that, in terms of corporate results, Vodafone Idea will be in focus. Now, the company reported a loss of 6,453 crores for the December quarter or FY20, as against a loss of 5,000 odd crores in the corresponding period last year. So it just suggests that the loss is actually widened by more than 1,000 crores on a year-on-year basis. And Sakshi, I believe that you're also tracking some stocks based on what brokerages are recommending.
Absolutely, Kshitij. Two stocks on my list. Let's start off with Ipca Laboratories first. Morgan Stanley has come out with a report on this one. It has an equal weight call on this stock with a target price at 1,299 rupees per share. Now, the company has actually stabilized its base business after the disruption due to the FDA issues, and that is what Morgan Stanley has reported. Apart from this, the company is poised for mid-teen sales growth and steady margin expansions, and that is what also Morgan Stanley believes. Apart from this, if you really see, the stock is trading at 21 times and 18 times FY21 expected earnings, and that implies full valuation right now. Apart from this, from the FMCG space, Nestle will be in focus, as Kotak has come out with a report on this one. It has a sell rating with a target at 14,000 rupees per share. Now, Q4 domestic growth print of 10% year-on-year is definitely ahead of peers. However, if you really see, the growth potential and the revived execution engine is priced in the valuations right now. So, limited upside over there. Yeah. Apart from this, we also have some technical recommendations for you. So, yes. Kshitij, what do we have for today?
Right. Well, to make your day more profitable, we spoke to India Nivesh Securities, and they've given us a buy and a sell call for today. The first stock that they have on the list is ONGC. Well, that's a buy for a target of 116 and a stop loss of 98. Aurobindo Pharma, well, that's a sell for a target of 490 and a stop loss of 555. Now, remember, the return potential is close to 7 to 10% on both these stocks. Well, these are not intraday trading ideas, but more of a positional play. So, in case you initiate any positions based on these recommendations, well, do consult your financial advisor.
Right. Thanks a lot, Kshitij, for sharing these ideas with us. And with that, it's a wrap here on this edition of Market at Start. You stay logged on to moneycontrol.com for more news and updates. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.